today. From SoFi Stadium in Inglewood, California. This is Madden NFL 21. See Tyrod Taylor and the LA Chargers taking on Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs.
Southern California has a new modern home for NFL football, and it is this place, wondrous SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood.
Today, it's a matchup in the AFC West between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Los Angeles Chargers.
The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. Here's Mecole Hardman. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
They often say you can't force situations. You just have to let them happen organically. And that's exactly what happened in Kansas City as Patrick Mahomes took over as the quarterback and has become the face of the franchise in the NFL as we now move into the 101st season. Fourth year in the league, already has an MVP, a Super Bowl title, and a Super Bowl MVP on his resume. Three huge games in the postseason last year, 10 touchdowns, just 2 interceptions, and 2 more on the ground. He just keeps getting better and better, and every time you watch him play, you want to see more.
From the 40 now on second down, Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw, it's Mahomes. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Throwing on first down is Mahomes. Flushed out right. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. It's Hill, complete. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
I have no crystal ball up here. I can't truly see into the future. But if they don't start getting some pressure on him, make him move around a little bit and do something with the receivers to, you know, change up their timing, they're just going to get shredded as we've seen so far. Right now, they're off to a blazing start.
Yeah, and you are right. He looks way too comfortable back there in the pocket.
Yeah, there shouldn't be a pillow back there for him, all right? If as a defensive guy, they've got to dump him on his backside a few times, shake things up.
Yeah, they're going to need an in-drive adjustment. And that is caught! Touchdown, Kansas City! DeMarcus Robinson there to make the grab. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead.
And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. But I think 158.3 is the number one.
Yep, that's
right. That's the highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on.
Unbelievable.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone, as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. The veteran Tyrod Taylor gets set to lead this Chargers offense as they take the field.
Many in the outside world see Tyrod Taylor as a bridge quarterback since the Chargers moved on from Phillip Rivers and drafted Justin Herbert. But head coach Anthony Lynn, he sees much more than that. They were together as play caller and quarterback in Buffalo when they went to the playoffs. And Coach Lynn believes that Tyrod Taylor can replicate that in Los Angeles.
Followed by Taylor here, and that's incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Hunter Henry, and that'll bring up second down. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with 3rd and 9 looming. On 3rd down, Taylor. Henry brings it in, and he works it across the 25 before being tackled. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down LA.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on 3rd down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go 3 and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down 2 scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5. Out of the gun, it's Taylor. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Frank Clark fighting his way home to get the sack.
2019 was the first season for Frank Clark in Kansas City after spending the previous 4 in Seattle. And that was a big move by Kansas City to bring him over. He did have 8 sacks in the regular season, but it was his 5 in postseason and helping his team get to the Super Bowl. That's why they went and acquired him. And by the way, earned his first Pro Bowl nomination with his play.
Third and long, Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. From the gun, it's Taylor. They complete it to Hill. And they're able to get this one across the 35. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Now it's Taylor. Throwing low, but it's incomplete. Mike Williams, the intended target, but it'll be second down.
All right, this gives us a chance, Charles, to go back to your playoff predictions. We covered the AFC. What do you see happening in the NFC?
All right, let's go with the division winners. Dallas in the East, Green Bay in the North. Let's see, New Orleans in the South, and out West, San Francisco. Wild cards, I think two are coming out, come from out West. Arizona and Seattle. And the third wild card, I think it's going to come from the South, and Tampa Bay gets in. Now, I don't believe Tampa Bay's going to the Super Bowl.
And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack. And that's Alex Okafor who gets in to register the sack. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
So on fourth down, here's Ty Long to punt for the Chargers. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. And they'll be looking to make this a two-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their first drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up two scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
Now a pass that's taken in by Hill. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Second and six. On play action, it's Mahomes. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And they'll go back to Robinson. This time he's got him. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. He had the touchdown on the opening drive. Now he's got a first down.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Drafted in April, this is Clyde Edwards-Helaire, and he'll be brought down right at midfield after a gain of only a couple.
And for Clyde Edwards-Helaire, no breaking him in gently in his NFL debut. Folks wondered if guys like Darwin Thompson and Darrell Williams might factor in a bit more, but not week one. 25 carries, 138 yards, and a touchdown in Clyde Edwards-Helaire's Chiefs debut.
And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They fake the give. Now Mahomes sliding out of the pocket. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Blitz came there from the inside, and there just wasn't much resistance.
No, not at all. That means that defensively, they timed it up perfectly and matched up perfectly. They drew all the blockers to the other guys, left a free runner back to the quarterback, and you know what a free runner turns into?
What?
A free hitter.
Hello.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game.
They've got second and 12 from the 36.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. Escaping the pressure right. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. And that will be incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And the lead moves to 10-0.
These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted, but I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yep.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists.
Well, and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason.
The Charger drive about to get going. Nothing for them yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10-0 as they come up first and 10. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Hill, the intended receiver, once again. That'll bring up second down.
Let's step into a different topic here for a second, Charles. You think about all the action that happened on Sunday, week one in the NFL.
And the Chiefs are going to get him. The sack comes from Anthony Hitchens.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game.
Third and long. Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. Taylor a handoff. It's Eckler. And they will bottle him up behind the line. And now will they use a timeout? The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Here's Ty Long now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Punt, 5 yards on the return, and possession will switch hands, first and 10. Out comes Patrick Mahomes in the Chiefs offense, and he's been fun to watch run the football. We know he can pass, but using his legs effectively here in this one.
No doubt about it. Watch him maneuver in the pocket, out of the pocket, making the plays that he's making, which are breaking down the defense. I thought back to when we had our morning jog before the game, and I couldn't keep up with you. Those legs, they're valuable for his team.
Mahomes now on first down. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
DeMarcus Robinson, the intended target on that one.
And it's second down.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call, but they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
And going deep for Hill, and that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. The Pro Bowler Tyreek Hill, the intended receiver, and that takes us from second to third down. Working from the gun, Mahomes. And it's It's complete to Kelsey.
And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards.
Mahomes now on first down. An incomplete. Crisis averted. Almost picked. Instead, second down. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Final shot before the half for Mahomes. He's going to fire one, corner of the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Chargers going to get the football first here in this second half, and they trail as we get back underway. This taken in about 4 yards deep, and no return here for Reed. This will be a touchback.
Now the quarterback, Tyrod Taylor, is our focus here in this player's spotlight. And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. Derek Nnadi makes the tackle.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. He's got a man. That's Keenan Allen. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Here's Ty Long now as he's on to punt for L.A. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number 2. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. The drive will begin with a run by Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Third quarter now from SoFi Stadium. Here's a 2nd and 10.
Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Jerry Tillery able to take him down. It's a loss of 3. So they come out of the locker room trailing, but plays like that, they won't be trailing much longer. Defense really starting out well this second half.
Yeah, they knew they had to jumpstart things a little bit. They really struggled in the first half trying to slow them down, but now they have a plan, made that adjustment that we always talk about, and it worked very well on that play.
And that is incomplete.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
Here's the Chiefs punter now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. A 40-yard punt, no return. L.A. set to take over again on offense.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Now he'll pull it down, and he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
They'll throw on first down with Taylor. Complete for Henry with the grab. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. That one good for 13 and a Charger first.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Nothing in that first half. Nothing on the last drive. But they're moving now with a 1st and 10. From the gun, Taylor, he's got it to Williams. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Out of the gun, Eckler running it. And he gets it down to the 32.
Now they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
Damian Wilson in on the stop. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. From the 27, Taylor, he's going to take off with it.
I think it's safe to say they can mark this down as extremely frustrating. Here we are in the fourth quarter, and that last play, that turnover, I think it epitomizes what happened to them all day on offense.
So symbolic, and that's why they're still being shut out.
Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over.
And they sit in a good spot, having the ball back after the fumble recovery and up 2 scores in the fourth quarter.
To the fumble recovery, it's Mahomes. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration.
Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. The tackle goes there to Linval Joseph. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys.
Mahomes hit. He lost the football and picked up by the Chargers. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game, so hold on here, not done in the fourth. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession.
They trail by two scores in the fourth, and their defense did its job getting the fumble recovery. And time to see what this offense has left in the tank.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Taylor.
There goes a deep ball, end zone.
He finds his receiver, Williams, for a Charger touchdown. Mike Williams, 37 yards. And the fumble recovery leads to 6 points for the Chargers. A sensational one-handed grab in the end zone for the score. Looked like you at the Davis Turkey Bowl every year in the backyard in Orlando, Florida.
Oh, you're so kind. That's definitely in my mind. But how about this? They always tell guys going after the ball, the receivers especially, you got to have a single-minded obsession to go get it. How about going up with a single hand and making that happen? I don't know if it gets much better than what we just saw there.
Michael Badgley on for the extra point. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. Well, the offense wasn't out there for a long time, but they were out there for a good time. One play, and they're able to hit pay dirt.
Long now will kick it away following the touchdown. Here's Hardman on the return. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
And the Chiefs now getting set to go.
And now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Out of the gun, he'll throw.
Flush to his right. He's going to take off with it. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
And now a shot into coverage downfield is complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
Not sure much more could have been done there defensively. Went up with him, tried to knock it away, tried to get an arm in unsuccessfully.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. Eluding the pressure right. And now he's going to use his legs. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can. And that's what he's done very well in this game.
On second down, a run with Edwards-Helaire.
And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Mahomes fair and complete. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask.
Can't do that.
Forgetting the yardage on the pass and half the distance to the goal line.
Because they're inside the 30, so now you don't march off the full 15, right? You have half the distance to the goal. In any event, that's precious real estate given up.
So now after the face mask penalty, here's first and goal. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. He was trying to get it to Tyreek Hill that time. But it'll be second and goal.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
That's complete right around the 8. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It'll be a loss of 1. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got it third and goal now as they look for that final touchdown to salt this one away. Flushed out right. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes finding Tyreek Hill. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Butker now to add the extra point. It's good to make it 17-7. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And this carries into the end zone. And this will come out to the 25 as Reed opts for the touchback. So now Tyrod Taylor and the Chargers down by 10, 1:55 remaining. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. Taylor to throw. He'll get this to Eckler. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Taylor going to try and hurry him to the line. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. They tried to throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and 1. Throwing now is Taylor. Tries for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. And they have the first down with that gain of 4 yards. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact. But in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Now it's Taylor. That's into the hands of Eckler. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Short play like that in this situation this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Madden used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them, not what they need.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. They're going on fourth down. It's Taylor. And Allen's got it.
And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. They were trying to go back to Allen there, but it's going to be second down. Taylor incomplete on first down. Here's second and 10. Here's Taylor. Got his man. It's Williams. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Open man, it's Allen. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. To throw again is Taylor. Escaping the pressure right. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
Whether it's a touchdown or a field goal, whatever it is, they need to score quickly here on first down. Taylor here, and that's incomplete.
Tight end has become a bigger and bigger part of the passing game in the NFL, but if you drop the football, that position could get swapped out with a wide receiver in that spot, a running back in that spot. There are other ways they can go if you're not going to catch the ball.
And that's not just his first drop, his second drop. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Third and long. Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Oh, no, he lost the football.
Let's get him. Come on.
One last shot for Taylor. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. So this one in the win column for Kansas City. And it was their defense that really paved the way to this victory as they allowed the one touchdown. And that was all she wrote.
Almost want to do the defense chant right now, right? Defense with a couple of claps in there, but no one wants to hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the run, control the airways, right? Make sure the quarterback is harassed. This type of performance you get. They can't fashion together any offense, no consistency, and they just took control.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.